线上的与会者早安，欢迎来到本次第36届 TWNIC IP 政策资源管理会议。首先，我们欢迎台湾网络资讯中心黄胜雄董事暨执行长为我们进行开场致辞。Let's welcome Dr. Kenny Huang, Member of the Board and CEO TWNIC, to give us welcome remarks. Dr. Huang, please.
好，谢谢啊，各位早。那首先非常谢谢各位参加第36届的 TWNIC IP-OPM IP Open Policy Meeting。 那这一次呢，我们总共有468位报名参与者。那 TWNIC IP-OPM 最主要是透过多方利害关系人的模式呢，那凝聚社群的共识，产出政策的文件，透过这个 PDP Policy Development Process 产出政策文件，然后订定 IP 相关的政策。那所以这个是非常重要，针对我们的政策治理、网络治理的整个面向，它是非常的重要。那首先再次感谢各位的参与。那我们今天的场次其实涵盖面非常的广，那包含今天的专题演讲，包括 Jeff Houston 从 APNIC， 他会介绍 BGP 的 Security 跟 Threat 跟未来的 Challenge， 然后有包括说未来 5G 的发展。那我们还有Cyber Security 6介绍各种资安样态的情资的分享，那有 Corporation 6介绍怎么样去提升利用资通讯的技术提升台环境的永续。那我们有我们组织的 Policy 6介绍，尤其这次会介绍 Abuse Contact， 就是网络滥用的时候的联系窗口，各个 Operator 电信业者的联系窗口怎么去阻绝这个网络的骇侵。那当然我们最重要的还有 IPv6 Deployment 6，介绍整个台湾地区 IPv6 的发展的概况。所以那接着我要介绍今天的几位贵宾来帮我们做贵宾的致辞。那下一位我要介绍的是邓维忠，通常会邓维忠委员来给我们说几句话，那我就交给邓维忠邓委员。
大家早安哈。我是国家通讯传播委员会哈，又称 NCC 的那个邓维忠。那今天就是非常高兴啊，能够代表 NCC 啊来参加第36届 TWNIC IP 政策资源管理会议。那因为每周三哈固定是我们 NCC 开委员会的日子啊，所以主委就不客前来哈。那他特别要我呢代为跟就是黄执行长各位与会嘉宾来致意。那就 NCC 来看，就是 TWNIC 是维护我国整体的这个资通讯网络基础建设的一个关键的角色，所以可说重中之重。那有时候我常开玩笑说，我们那个黄执行长可能这个去行政院和这个总统府开会的次数比我们家的主委还要多。那这两年呢，随着这个台湾的 OTT TV 服务的普及以及 5G 行动通讯的这个试照，那台湾的网络环境其实就是虽然看似成熟，但是仍然持续充满着活力，日新又新的不断的在演进。那 NCC 很感谢黄执行长，就是就他就任来这几年带领这个 TWNIC 同仁面对这些新的网际网络治理的这些各项议题，那持续的积极的参与讨论，然后伸出这个解决方案，并且呢切实的去对这个执行后续的这个落实。那说到这个网际网络的话，我想有很多先进可能有听说了，就是三个月前那非洲那边的 Afrinic 他们的银行账户被冻结，那很多外界就很关心也很担心，可能网际网络运作是不是会出问题。那还有这个包含今天早上的新闻，这个 app 那个 Facebook 那有6个小时他们的那个服务终端无法登入。那这个在台湾呢，我很庆幸啊，就是说在我们 NCC 和 TWNIC 同仁的以及各电信业者的这种大家的这个通力合作之下，在台湾我们很少会听到有这样子的一个人为因素所造成的一个资通讯基础建设的服务的中断。那我也希望说接下来仍然能够和 TWNIC 一起合作，那稳健的 持续的推动台湾的资通讯网络基础建设啊，来往前迈进。那最后祝大家今天收获满满，那今天的会议圆满成功，谢谢。
谢谢邓维中委员 ，Thank you, Dr. Deng。接下来，让我们欢迎 APNIC 主席 Paul Wilson 为我们致辞。Next, let's welcome the Director General of APNIC, Paul Wilson, to give us opening remarks. Paul Wilson, please.
Thank you so much. Good morning and greetings, everyone. To Wei Chung Teng, the Commissioner for NCC, Kenny Guang, who's not only the CEO of TWNIC, but also the treasurer of my own board, the APNIC EC. To all of APNIC's friends at TWNIC and in the Taiwan community, it's really great to be back here at this meeting, the 36th of your IP-OPM meetings. And it's great to see how this event has developed in the past few years. It's a great program, and I hope everyone who's here can take advantage of the content that's on offer today, including the cybersecurity SIG, the cooperation and policy and IPv6 development SIGs. And I'm sure that'll be an interesting and important set of sessions for everyone. I really do commend TWNIC for your leadership in bringing together the agenda and also bringing together the Taiwan Internet technical community, along with other stakeholders, such as the NCC, because this really is the spirit of multi-stakeholder cooperation. That's the true strength of the internet globally. It's also great that this meeting is continuing even in these difficult COVID circumstances. I really do wish that I could be there in person, but hopefully next time. But even in these times, APNIC has tried to keep in close touch with TWNIC and with TWNIC events. Earlier this year, we joined the 35th IPOPM and also the ICANN TWNIC Forum, which were held in April. We presented an online tutorial on routing security and RPKI in May. And we've actually got another online tutorial on SDN, that's software-defined networking, which is coming up in October, later this month. And I hope that some of you at least can join that one. For today, I'm very happy that Jeff Houston will follow this morning with a keynote on BGP. And also later today, George Kuo from APNIC with an update from our last open policy meeting from the policy SIG of APNIC 52, because we had a very active SIG meeting just a couple of weeks ago with 7 proposals, and that was a record. And I'd like to, you will hear about those proposals, but I'd like to give my sincere thanks to Ching-Heng Ku, who you all know, who is the co-chair of that session and has been helping out very, very, very well in the last few years. So this year and next year, APNIC's got a couple of special focus areas that I'd like to mention to you, because I know that TWNIC shares these priorities with APNIC. First is what we call the Next Generation Registry, and I've spoken about this before at TWNIC meetings. This includes the development of new registry services, primarily RDAP, the Registration Data Access Protocol, and RPKI, the Registration Public Key Infrastructure. But we're also adding to that the provision of API, Application Programming Interface, access to our registry services. And this year, in fact, we will launch an API for interface between APNIC and the NIRs, including TWNIC, and TWNIC has been very involved with that development. So we look forward to launching that new service. But also related to next generation registry is a focus that we have these days on security, stability, and integrity of all registry services. Because as the internet grows, our reliance on IP address registry services also grows, and that's absolutely required to support the security and stability of the internet itself. So we do need to work together. We need to work together with the security community as well to ensure that our registries are fit for purpose and to ensure that the registries always contain information which is reliable and as accurate as possible. So to that end, APNIC's working with the NIRs, with TWNIC, of course, on implementation of the IPv4 transfer policies and transfer registrations throughout the region, because as transfers become more important in supporting the distribution of addresses, the registration of IPv4 transfers also needs to be tracked very accurately. So finally, I also know that TWNIC is implementing improvements in the abuse contact validation within the registry, and I do believe you'll be hearing more about that later today as well. So this is going to be a busy day for you all, and I should get out of the way and allow you to continue. But once again, I'd just like to finish by saying congratulations and thanks to TWNIC on this meeting. And I really do hope that you all have a great day. Thanks very much.